Look at these pictures. Can you tell me the common thing used in these materials in the picture? The common thing used to make all these materials. Yes, the material to make all these things is obtained from rocks. You know, our earth is made up of soil and rocks. Deep inside the earth, it is mostly rocks. You take a piece of rock and look at the piece of rock using a magnifying glass, you can see small grains. These small grains are called minerals. So rocks are made up of minerals. Minerals are the building blocks of rocks. Minerals are the building blocks of rocks. Do you know the different types of rocks? Do you know how different rocks are formed? So today, let's discuss about rocks in detail. We have to start with our second lesson. Lesson 2, Rocks and Minerals. So first, let us discuss about rocks. I said, rocks are made up of minerals. Each rock has one or two minerals of different colors. Based on the formation, rocks are classified into three types. They are igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. So based on the formation, rocks are classified into three types. They are igneous rocks, metamorphic rocks, and sedimentary rocks. So first, let us discuss about the formation of igneous rock and also different types of igneous rocks. Then we have to study about the formation of sedimentary rock, different types of sedimentary rock, metamorphic rock, different types of metamorphic rocks. So first, let us discuss about the formation of igneous rock and the different types of igneous rocks. Igneous means produced from fire. So I told you, deep inside the earth, it is mostly rocks. And there is also high temperature deep inside the earth. Due to this high temperature, the rocks melts. This molten rock is known as magma. So what is magma? The molten rock deep inside the earth is known as magma. This magma exerts high pressure and it comes to the surface of the earth. The raised surface of the earth is called as volcano. When it comes to the surface of the earth, it is known as lava. This lava, when comes in contact with air and water, it gets solidified and form igneous rock. Understand? Deep inside the earth's crust, it is mostly rocks, and due to high temperature, these rocks melt. This molten rock is known as magma. Due to high pressure, this magma comes to the surface of the earth. When it reaches the surface of the earth, it is known as lava. This lava, when comes in contact with air and water, solidifies and form the igneous rock. Now you look at this picture. You can see the magma. Then, due to the pressure, magma comes to the surface. The raised surface is called volcano. When it reaches the surface, it is called lava. When it comes in contact with air and water, it solidifies and forms the igneous rock. Igneous rock is also known as fiery rock. Igneous rock is also known as fiery rock. Depending on how the magma cools, igneous rocks are of different types. Sometimes the magma solidifies under the earth's crust itself. Sometimes the magma spills out through a crack formed on the crust. Sometimes it rushes out, forming a volcano, and it reaches the surface, then it is called as lava, then solidifies. So depending upon how the magma cools, igneous rocks are of different types. So we have discussed about the formation of igneous rocks. Hope you all have understood that. And now let us discuss about the types of igneous rock. I told you, based on how the magma cools, there are different types of rocks. The first one is granite. Types of igneous rock. First one is granite. Granite is formed when magma cools slowly under the earth's crust. Granite is formed when the magma cools slowly under the earth's crust. I told you, deep inside the earth's crust, it is mostly rock. Rocks melt due to the high temperature. This molten material is known as magma. Sometimes this magma do not come to the surface of the earth. Before that, it will slowly cools under the earth's crust. Such rocks are called as granite. Granite is very hard and has large grains. You all have seen granite, isn't it? So granite is very hard and has large grains. It is made up of three minerals. Mainly there are three minerals: feldspar, quartz and mica. Feldspar, quartz and mica. Depending upon the color of minerals, granite may be of white, gray, pink, red or black. I told you, rocks are made up of minerals. Each rock has one or two minerals of different colors. So granite has mainly three minerals: feldspar, quartz and mica. Depending upon the color of these minerals, granite may be of white, gray, pink, green or red. It is also used in buildings and statues. So granite is formed when the magma cools slowly under the earth's crust. It has large grains and it is very hard. It may be of different colors depending upon the color of mineral it contains. It is used in buildings and statues. The second type of igneous rock is basalt. Basalt is formed when volcanic lava cools very fast when it reaches the surface of the earth. I told you, magma when reaches the surface of the earth, it is called lava. This lava cools when it comes in contact with air and water. So the lava cools very fast. When it comes in contact with air and water, it gets hardened and forms the basalt. Basalt can be seen in dark colors and it has fine grains. It also has a glassy texture. So it is a glassy rock. Basalt is a glassy rock. It is also used in construction. Second type of igneous rock is basalt. The second type of igneous rock is basalt. Basalt is formed when